I must admit that when I started preparing my homily, I felt intimidated by the fact that the theme of God's law kept popping out, and that I would have to talk about law to a parish that seems to be full of lawyers. But after further reflection, I don't think our readings are just about laws and following the law. I think that is just the surface of what the Holy Spirit is calling us to prayerfully discern.
Because it's not.
from above, coming down from the Father of lights. St. James continues, he will to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. When we accept the word made flesh, Jesus Christ, who is the fulfillment of the law, then we are choosing the highest of all goods. Jesus came to perfect the law and to fulfill it. Jesus summed up the whole law into two commandments: love God and love your neighbor as yourself. That's it. If we do those two things, then we will always choose good and never stray from the good, who is God. By reading and listening to God's word, and receiving the word made flesh in the Eucharist, we will remain in union with our Almighty Father, and become the love that He is. St. James continues to say, humbly welcome the word that has been planted in you and is able to save your souls. Be doers of the word. At the end of each holy sacrifice of the Mass, we are charged to go and to announce the gospel of the Lord, or to glorify the Lord by our lives. We aren't meant to sit here, listen to the Father or the Deacon babble on, and then go to breakfast and continue living our lives as we did before. We are meant to hear the word, receive the word made flesh in the Eucharist, and then go and be the word. Go out and be Jesus Christ. Care for the orphans and widows. Feed the hungry. Care for the sick. And most